The Heisenberg uncertainty principle is a thing you've almost certainly heard about before. If not from school, then from technobabble on sci-fi shows. You probably know a very basic summary, that the position and velocity of a particle cannot both be measured exactly at the same time, before Spock veers off into vaguely understandable lunacy, that is. So before we can talk about what the uncertainty principle is, we have to know what it isn't. First, the uncertainty principle isn't caused by humans. The uncertainty principle has often been confused or explained by the observer effect, which describes how measurements of a certain system cannot be made by changing something in that system, including by Heisenberg himself, who suggested the observer effect as a physical explanation for quantum uncertainty. However, the uncertainty principle is not caused by limitations in technology that we can somehow circumvent, looking at you, Star Trek. It's an actual inherent property of quantum systems. The uncertainty principle actually exists because everything in the universe behaves like both a particle and a wave at the same time. Under quantum mechanics, the exact position and speed of an object have no meaning. To understand why, we first have to understand what it means to behave like a particle or a wave. Particles exist, by definition, in a single place at a single instant point in time, which can be represented by a graph illustrating the probability of finding a particle at a given point. It looks like a spike, 100% at that one specific position, and zero everywhere else. Waves, however, are spread out in space like ripples in a swimming pool. While it's possible to identify certain features of that wave pattern, like the wavelength, it's impossible to assign it a single position. It has a probability of being in loads of different places. This measure of wavelength is especially important in quantum physics because it corresponds to momentum, or mass times velocity. The higher the momentum, the shorter the wavelength. While most everyday stuff does not move that fast, it does have a very short wavelength because it's comparatively massive on a quantum scale, but it's also why we don't notice the wave nature of everyday objects. The average adult human, for instance, has a wavelength of just 10 to the negative 32 meters, far too small to ever notice or detect. Small subatomic things, however, like electrons or photons, have larger wavelengths that we can actually detect in physics experiments. If we have such a pure wave, we can measure its wavelength and thus momentum, but we don't have any idea as to its position. We do know a particle's position almost exactly, but it, by definition, has no wavelength, and thus, we can't know its momentum. In order to roughly find both the position and momentum of a particle, we need to create a graph that has waves, but only in a very small area, which can be done by adding a bunch of waves together. When we do so, we can see that there are places where the peaks line up, creating a high wave, and places where waves cancel out, forming a plateau. The more waves we add, the bigger our plateaus get, and the narrower and taller our waves get. If we keep on adding waves, we can make what's called a wave packet, which has a clear wavelength in one relatively small area. This packet is a quantum object that has features of both a wave and a particle, but in order to get this, we had to sacrifice the accuracy of both position and momentum. The position isn't one point. There's a probability of finding a particle within the region of that wave packet. The momentum is imprecise too, because the wave packet is the result of adding a whole bunch of waves together, and thus we aren't quite sure what the true wavelength is. It's impossible to make any one of those two values more precise without compromising on the other. That's the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, which is an inevitable outcome of combining particles and waves.